One of the first things that you need to do once you have your Microsoft 365 subscription initially configured is you need to go ahead and add some user accounts. All right, so here in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center, you'll notice on the left there is an option here for users. And if we expand that down, you could then click on active users. And you'll notice I only have the one user, just me. Okay, and so that was the one that was created by default. It's got my name because I had tied my name to the subscription, and the username is admin at our domain name. If I want to go ahead and add an additional user, I just click on the link for add a user. And now we could create a user. So we'll say demo, first name, user. How about that? Demo user. Automatically, when I click on display name, it populates based upon what I put in for first and last name. The username, I'm going to actually just put in D user, so like first initial, last name. Again, you need to come up with a naming convention that works for your organization. And you'll notice that the domain, it defaults to landonhotel620.com because that is what we went ahead and connected to that domain. But if we wanted to change that, that was the default. Well, I could also go ahead and make this demo user be part of landonhotel1021.onmicrosoft.com. Okay, so if you have multiple domains, you can choose them here, but it will always go to the default one. You can automatically create a password and then require the user to change their password at the first sign-in, and you can even send a password in email upon completion. What I would like to do is not automatically create a password, and I'm going to go ahead and put in a password for this particular user. And in this case, I'm going to not require them to change a password when they first sign in. But again, this is only because we're in a demo learning environment. In the real world, you would set up a temporary password and you would require them to change their password. In our demo environment, I don't want to have to keep changing passwords, so I'll just set it up and I'm good to go. So I'm going to click on next. And now we need to go ahead and decide on a product license. Okay, so we have our Office 365 E5 subscription. There are 25 licenses available, so we can go ahead and assign this user a license so this user can actually use the different products in our trial version here. Or I could create the user without any licenses, but then they would have basically no access to the features. By the way, if I didn't want to give them the full Office 365, you see here I can expand apps. And then I can manually decide specifically which licenses within Microsoft 365 E5 we're going to give them. Now I'll just leave them all. So I'm going to click on next. And this now takes us to some optional settings, which the first optional setting here has to do with roles. Okay, it says no administration access. But we could go ahead. I mean, it's a regular user right now. I could go ahead and I could make this particular user an admin. And you'll see here that there's the option of a number of different administrators. And if you hover over the little info thing, it'll tell you what this particular administrator can do. And you'll notice I'm hovering over global administrator. Global administrators have unlimited access to all management features and most data in all admin centers, right? So I'm going to go ahead and what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually select global administrator because it is always a good idea that you have at least two global administrators in case something happens to one of the accounts. But you do want to be careful. You don't want to create too many global admins because that can be a security concern. All right. In fact, I believe they recommend anywhere between 2 and 4 at the most. And these are accounts that shouldn't log in for everyday use. They should be used just for administration. Now, you'll also see here there is show by category, where I could see there's a whole lot of additional administrators that I could choose from as well. There's also some additional profile info that we could put in if I wanted to give information about this particular user. I'm not going to do that at this point. I just wanted to show you that was some more optional information I could do. I'm going to click on next and finish adding. And just like that, if I click on close, you'll see here I now have the original Ed Lieberman account, but I also now have a demo user account. All right. And both of them have been set up as global administrators, which means both will have full capabilities helping to administrate Microsoft 365. Now, beyond that, you want to go ahead and just continue adding users and setting them up each individually, or while I'm not going to go into any detail here, I do want to show you that there is an option for adding multiple users. Okay. And so there is the ability to actually use like a CSV file to go ahead and do a mass import of users if that is something that you need to do in your organization. During the process of adding a user, one of the options that we have is to go ahead and immediately assign them some form of administrative role so that they can perform certain administrative duties in Microsoft 365. Behind the scenes, I created four other users. I have another demo user, okay, which is just a regular user account that has no roles assigned in the onmicrosoft.com domain. And then I created user 1, 2, and 3, which are also just regular users, no administrative roles assigned, but they are all in the .com domain. Okay, I just wanted to have a variety here so we can look at all sorts of different things. So one way that we can go ahead and we can manage these roles is by just clicking on a user after they've already been created. And then you'll see here that we have roles and it says no administrative access. Click on manage roles. And it takes us back into the screen that we saw when we were creating the user, where we can go ahead and give admin center access. And here are the recommended highly used admin accounts. And if you hover over the little information, it'll tell you what each one does. You can also say show all by category, and you'll see there is quite the long list where you can get very, very descript. Okay, so I'm going to actually take one very specific one. I'm going to say that another demo user is a security admin, right? So I'm going to go ahead and check that box and click save changes. You'll see here it says the role has been updated. I'm going to click to go back. And it should, you know, see, sometimes it doesn't refresh automatically right away. So it says still no administrator access. I'm going to hit the little refresh button here. And of course, it still says no administrator access. So let's go ahead and close this. I'm going to actually go ahead and refresh this entire active user's screen, go back into another demo user. And you'll see here that now you can see that that user is a security admin. Okay, I intentionally wanted to show you that that doesn't always refresh automatically right away. It will in time. I mean, I would say within a minute, maybe a couple, 5 minutes tops, it would automatically refresh, but you can always force the refresh as well. All right, so that's one way that you can manage the roles. Another way you can do it is over on the left, there's an option for roles. Now you'll notice there's nothing here that says roles. So we're gonna click on show all, and now we have an option for roles. So I'm gonna expand that. And I'm going to click on role assignments. And here again, you see the default recommended roles. Like here's global administrator, for instance. And if I click on global administrator, you'll see here that it gives the recommendation on who should be assigned the role and how it should be used and this and that. And it says that we have two assigned admins. And if I click on assigned admins on that tab, you can see that Ed Lieberman and demo user are both global administrators. But let's click on show all roles and let's scroll all the way down to that security admin role. Here you'll see under general, it went back to assigned admins, that's where we were. It'll say who should be assigned this role. Okay, it gives that. It says there's one assigned admin. If I click on it, we know that's another demo user. But if we wanted to add additional admins, I can click it here. And if I start typing in a name, so let's put in like user, you see how I have user 1, 2, and 3. I can click on user 1. And let's say I even wanted to do another one. So I'll put in user and we'll select user 2. User 1 and user 2, click save. They've now been assigned the roles. And you can see that we now have 3 security admins in our organization. If I click on the general tab, it also says there are 3 assigned admins. And in fact, if I were to jump back to my active users, and if I were to click on, let's say, user 1, you will see here, and again, you'll notice it did not refresh automatically. Let me try refreshing this way. You'll see here now, under roles, it says user 1 is a security admin. So you can see from either direction that the role has been assigned. All right, so again, the roles are really what go ahead and define what administrative access users can have in your organization. And you can do it either from the users, where you assign a role individually, or you can go over to the roles section and go ahead and put in, you know, blocks of users and assign all their various roles from there.